customizable template for patient
consent form. This is a really basic one.
Yeah, that's a super basic. Okay.
Right, you select a provider name. Like you can put a list of providers in the on your practice.
Select the provider.
Boilerplate text if you have any. Now you select the procedure they want. Like if there's 100 procedures, like okay, I'm doing this procedure, I'm doing this procedure.
Okay. And this injects text into the note.
Save.
Wait, what was that? The signature section. What is that?
It's basically a bunch of lines. That's it.
Okay.
For them to put a signature.
Okay. So that's a section. Okay. Yes. And that's in the form builder itself, correct?
Yes.
So you can select a signature section in the form builder.
No, there's no signature section.
Okay, this is just lines.
It's a hack.
Okay, yeah. So you made lines.
Yeah, I hack it.
A space,
yes.
Lots of space.
Look, have a look at this.
Okay.
So I have the boilerplate text.
Okay.
I have the procedures, I want to do it.
Okay.
I have more boilerplate text. I created a little...
I see, so this is your own signature section. Now this sign is always here, this little icon.
Yeah. There's a name, you could customize it whatever you like. But right now we take the name of the consent after the template name.
Uh-huh.
Now if I sign in, I go to the bottom, I had a signature. Now this is a safe signature.
Yep. For yourself, okay.
See my name?
So that's your name. And then for the patient is right in front of you, right here.
And then like
you're
okay.
Next to the patient. Okay.
Yeah. And then we'll go out of signature. We'll call it picture signature. And we take the name from the chart and sign. And now you have a patient name with their signature. Now if you need
Got
a witness.
It. Okay.
Right.
So what you're down the road you're gonna have a way to
lock
allow to hand it over to the patient locked.
Yeah. They can still hit the home button, but it'll be locked.
Okay.
Okay, but watch. So let's put another signature. And this time we'll have a witness. But when this is on. Two.
Mm-hmm.
And now you have a witness.
So that is someone else that came in.
Yes. So now you have a consent form. The patient has consented.
And you with all three of your signatures right there.
Yes. And then.
In front of you.
Yeah. And now after you finish sending, you have a document. With the procedures, the boilerplate text. And or save three signatures.
Okay.
The doctor usually, like, they go like this. Okay, son.
Yep.
Here's all the procedures I'm going to do on you today.
This. They walk
procedure
you through
one.
It. Yep.
Right, yeah.
They walk you through
because
it all.
That's interacting with the patient, you, by showing you these procedures. I'm like, here's what I'm going to do. Okay. Here's what I'm going to do. All right. Here's the risk involved.
Yep.
Okay. You.
Doctor signs. Patient signs, witness signs.
Yes.
Depending on if you can delete the witness. And you did that all in the as a free text field in the form builder. And you called it signature.
Yes.
Okay.
Then I could save it.
And then how do you exclude it from the clinical note?
You can't do it yet. That's what we're building.
So right now it's in the clinical note. So down the road there'll be an
He every time he unchecks everything. Then he views the complete note.
But where's that signed section? That is just what we did. This is what me and you did, and there's my signature.
Now you can send
so it saved the copy even though you unchecked everything.
Yes.
How did it save the copy?
Because we created a PDF.
You hit view complete note, it gets placed here?
You don't have to view complete note. That's the beauty of it then. We just save a section. And it creates a PDF based on that section.
Okay.
So you never had to create a view complete note because when you save section, it generates the text.
Yeah.
And you can create a PDF from that.
And then it's just saved in the history. And you can also see the history here, right?
Yes.
Say patient history right here. It should be here also, right?
Yeah.
And it's that same thing.
Now you can send this to the patient. Send it to one patient.
Yep.
Again, if I do it. Again, this never changes, you know? Like, this is...
All the procedures you're going to do, you do the signature section, you go there.
Save section.
Okay. It goes in here.
It generates a PDF.
Yeah.
And then you can go into the signature section and sign it.
And you can have them sign it right here. The patient?
Yeah.
Okay.
Save it.
Okay.
Save the PT history.
Okay.
And then you're done. So now... Because I have one patient, I can send them one patient.
Okay.
Now I, right, so I just send it to my on patient.
Okay, so you just sent it to on patient.
Mm-hmm.
Go here, pull down, go here,
just now.
Go here.
Here's my consent form.
So the patient has a copy of it.
Yes.
But you have to enable on patient on the web right now.
You have to connect with the patient first.
So you connect on the web, so the iPad doesn't have the connector. It's
it
all
does.
On the web.
It does.
Where would you do that?
Patient information. You could turn it on.
Okay. So this is where you turn on patient on. So where was that? You go here? Where was that?
Patient information.
Okay.
We had to modify a little bit, but we designed
okay.
it.
Okay. But that's where it is right now. Is that live?
So if you
that's
connect,
live.
But if you connect it with the patient, you have this option.
Got
to send it.
It
to on patient.
Okay.
So you see now.
Yes.